like a good time for some good news here. The House passed the space budget yesterday, 277 to 60, which includes a vote for the shuttle.
Wonderful.
6, 5, 4, we've gone for main engine start.
We have main engine start and ignition and liftoff of STS-7 and America's first woman astronaut. And the shuttle has cleared the tower.
Hey, roll program.
Roger your roll, Challenger.
And liftoff of the 25th space shuttle mission, and it has cleared the tower.
Liftoff, Americans return to space as Discovery clears the tower.
Roger roll, Discovery.
Crew confirms roll program, Houston now controlling. Three engines at 104%. Good APUs, three good fuel cells.
Go for main engine start. We are go for main engine start. T-minus 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and liftoff of the Space Shuttle Discovery with the Hubble Space Telescope, our window on the universe.
And we have liftoff. Liftoff of the Space Shuttle Endeavour on an ambitious mission to service the Hubble Space Telescope. And liftoff of the Space Shuttle Atlantis on a mission that will herald a new day of international cooperation in space.
And liftoff of Space Shuttle Columbia with a multitude of national and international space research experiments.
And liftoff of Space Shuttle Discovery, beginning America's new journey to the Moon, Mars, and beyond. And the vehicle has cleared the tower.
This animation shows how they work during launch. The two solid rocket boosters strapped to each side carry their own propellants and burn for about 2 minutes before separating. Their onboard parachutes will then bring them back to Earth for recovery and reuse. The large external fuel tank continues feeding the shuttle engines for an additional 6 minutes, separating just before the shuttle reaches orbit. This is the only part of the shuttle system that will not be used again. Two milestone events, the rollout of NASA's Space Shuttle Orbiter 101 and its subsequent overland move to the Dryden Flight Research Center for flight tests, mark the very visible beginnings of this country's future space system. Christened the Enterprise, the Shuttle Orbiter is our first reusable spaceship, able to fly a mission beyond Earth, return, land, and then be launched over and over again, achieving cost reductions through its round-trip use.
We now recommend 50% speed brakes.
5,295.
Speed brakes coming in now.
Just open up about 2 feet. You're on. Okay, your nose wheel's about 10 feet. About 5.
I suggest you go ahead and start your engines and begin your taxi.
Thank you.
Starting to turn to final.
Starting to turn to final.
160 Chase. Flaps coming to 10.
Fido says it looks super.
Copy. 4, 3, 2, 1. We'll see you, babe.
Okay, that's great.
Houston, copy, pushover.
Accelerating now.
You're on the glide slope. We see you on the glide slope.
2,300. Gear's coming. See the gear coming. Anchors down. Ten feet, 5 feet, 1 foot, down. Nose is coming down.
You know, now there's a 20th century Enterprise, an actual space vehicle built by NASA and designed to put us in the business of space. Now the shuttle will be taking scientists and engineers, men and women of all races, into space just like the astronaut crew on the Starship Enterprise. So that is why I'm speaking to the whole family of humankind, minorities and women alike. If you qualify and would like to be an astronaut, now is the time. This is your NASA, a space agency embarked on a mission to improve the quality of life on planet Earth right now.
For the first time, all the major components of the space shuttle transportation system came together for testing. When completely assembled, the shuttle orbiter will sit astride two recoverable solid rockets and atop a giant external fuel tank. The entire system was subjected to vibrations similar to those that will occur at launch. At the Thiokol Corporation facility in Utah, a shuttle booster that will produce about 2.65 million pounds of thrust at launch was successfully test-fired again. Each of the space shuttle's three main engines that will provide the orbiter with its primary power from launch pad almost to Earth orbit were also successfully tested. Work is continuing on the second shuttle orbiter at the Rockwell plant in California. This is the spacecraft that will actually make the first flight with astronauts Young and Crippen at the controls. 47-year-old John Young, veteran of two Gemini and two Apollo space flights, will be commander for the first manned shuttle mission. Here, he practices making landings in a space shuttle simulator at the Johnson Space Center with Robert Crippen, the 40-year-old astronaut who will fly with Young as pilot.
The years of research and development would now be put to the ultimate test. The first flight into space of Shuttle Columbia with astronauts at the controls. Despite nagging problems with engines and protective tiles, there was a quiet optimism. Longtime space workers knew from past experience with the lunar landing program that design and engineering problems do get worked out.
Thank you.
Anticipating the Space Shuttle's flight schedule in the years ahead, NASA selected 35 new candidate astronauts in 1978 to begin training as shuttle mission specialists and pilots. The 35, including six women, were chosen from nearly 8,000 applicants and will be training until mid-1980.
Minus 2 hours, 5 minutes, and holding, about 23 minutes remaining in this built-in hold as the astronauts John Young and Bob Crippen drive off toward the pad.
This is shuttle launch control. The countdown stands at T-minus 33 minutes, 10 seconds, and counting. At the present time, everything going smoothly. We're looking for a launch on time at 7 a.m. this morning.
This is shuttle launch control. We are presently at T-minus 9 minutes and holding, but a decision has been made to recycle the count to the T-minus 20-minute point.
At the present time, the ground people are working a problem with the backup computer compare test. We are standing by to hear what the resolution of that particular problem might be.
Any other inputs that would lead us towards any other course of action?
This is shuttle launch control. During the countdown, we have been not able to get the computers talking to each other properly.
At the present time, we have terminated our launch attempt for today and will reschedule for no earlier than Sunday morning at 6:50 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. This is shuttle launch control.
Through you today, we all feel as giants once again. Once again, we feel a surge of pride that comes from knowing we are the first, we are the best, and we are so because we are free. For all Americans, Nancy and I thank you and thousands of others who have worked to make this day possible. May God bless you, and may God bring you safely home to us again.
T-minus 1 minute, 20 seconds, and counting. We can see the purges of the main engines as we prepare for ignition. T-minus 1 minute, 10 seconds, and counting. Liquid hydrogen tank is at flight pressure. T-minus 1 minute, mark, and counting.
GC flight. No flight. Is the mile a problem, the entire S-band, or just ranging?
It's just the tracking data, flight, just the tracking data.
But it's everything, angles, ranging?
Everything.
Okay.
Right, flight.
T-minus 40 seconds and counting. The development flight instrumentation recorders are on. T-minus 35 seconds. We're just a few seconds away from switching to the redundant sense sequencer. T-minus 27 seconds. We have gone for redundant sense sequencer start. T-minus 15, 14, 13, 15, 14, 13, 14, 13, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14, 14
as advertised all the way along. A few little minor news problems, but nothing of significance. I guess the major one you guys are working on down there is dealing with some of our instrumentation. But I think we've got something that's really going to mean something to the country and the world. This vehicle is performing like a champ, like all of us that have worked so long on knew that you would. I guess in acknowledging people that have done a lot for the program, I think it's only right that we mentioned a couple of guys that gave their lives a few weeks ago in our countdown demonstration test, John Bjornstad and Forrest Cole. They believed in the space program. It meant a lot to them. I'm sure they'd be thrilled to see where we have the vehicle now.
Going over the hill. Nice and easy does it, John. We're all riding with you.
Bye-bye.
Mission Control, chase planes are taking off now at Edwards. Here in the control center, the backup crew for this mission, astronauts Joe Engel and Dick Truly behind the capcoms.
Convoy crew is all ready to go out there. They're the crew that will safe the orbiter and help with the power down.
Stand by for mark 9,700 feet per second.
Hello there, Houston. Columbia's here.
Hello, Columbia. Houston's here. How do you read?
Flying clear, and we're doing Mach 10.3 at 180 AS.
And we couldn't agree more, John. Your state vector's good. We've got a good data in
hand. Okay, I'll see you later.
Over there is nominal. In fact, how do I look exactly nominal?
Columbia's reentry expected to produce a mild sonic boom centered a few miles west of Edwards Air Force Base.
What a way to come to California.
In flat photo, I still look perfect right on the nominal.
Real good underneath. Fido says it couldn't be any better. 9,000.
we're going to test it off first.
The world screen is all electric flying machine, I'll tell you that. It was super.
This is Mission Control Houston, the unofficial touchdown time, 2 days, 6 hours, 20 minutes, 52 seconds. As Columbia's main gear touched the lake bed, the flight director's instructions were prepare for acceleration.
Okay, we'll go to questions now here in Houston, and then we'll move to the other centers. If I don't call on you by name, please give your name and affiliation when the mic gets to you. John Gitter.
Dr. Wright, during your training exercises as a member of this group, when there was a problem, when there was a funny, a glitch or whatever, how did you respond? How do you take it as a human being? Do you weep? What do you do?
Why doesn't anybody ask Rick those questions?
It's the commander weeps.
I don't think that I react any differently than anybody else on the crew does.
Do you feel that the coverage that has been given has been disproportionate with regards to the first American woman in space?
I think that it's maybe too bad that our society isn't further along and that this is such a big deal. But I guess if the American public thinks that it's a big deal, then it's probably good that it's getting the coverage that it's getting. I think it's time that we get away from that, and it's time that people realize that women in this country can do any job that they want to do.
T-minus 35 seconds. We're just a few seconds away from switching command to the onboard computers. We've gone for auto sequence start.
25.
T-minus 25 seconds and counting. The sequencer on board now controlling the final seconds. T-minus 17 seconds and counting. The body flap and speed breaker in launch position. T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. We go for main engine start. We have main engine start. And ignition. And liftoff. Liftoff of STS-7 and America's first woman astronaut. And the shuttle has cleared the tower.
pretty good flying machine you got here.
Roger, I can see the smile on your face from here.
Satellite looks in excellent condition.
Doesn't work.
Thank you, Rita.
Lardivian, I don't know if he's docked yet or not.
Hydraulic didn't fire.
EVA, Jaws didn't fire. Do you have a...
Roger again, he didn't fire again.
Double check on the little commissioner over the connector. It's still up, and I can get ready for the
We dedicate this week's New Hampshire Up Close to the memory of Krista McAuliffe. As we are all too well aware, the one-year anniversary of the Space Shuttle Challenger explosion is just a few days away. Many reporters have again converged on Concord, seeking to revive some of the sad memories through their often insensitive questioning. We here at NHT were too close to the story to choose to remember the tragedy. Instead, 1 year later, we choose to look back at Krista's contributions, at her dreams and her life. Remember Krista McAuliffe at her enthusiastic best, and not the few seconds of fire that took her away.
Another light.
They had 95 million questions, and I couldn't answer them because I just didn't have the time. Teachers are excited about this bill. I spoke to that group in Dallas last night.
How many were there?
About 250. It was industry plus teaching.
Videotape real well.
Oh, they loved it.
Yeah, because
C should be smaller.
Because we could try it all sorts of ways. We could try it Velcro and just kind of tapping it to see what would happen. I could do a free flow because I've got 2.5 minutes. So if you put on here, we could try it Velcro and then I could try a free flow.
When it came up that time, it was just as high.
Yeah, it's directly overhead. It's 96.
Carol sent me a t-shirt that somebody had. She had seen a t-shirt on the beach, and she went and had one made. And it says, "I touch the future. I teach." And I really appreciate that sentiment, and that's going to go with me. Thanks a lot.
Nine, eight, seven, go for main engines. At this moment, our place in the heavens makes us feel closer to them than ever before.
Those on the Challenger who had flown before and seen these sights, they would know the meaning of our thoughts. Those who had gone to view them for the first time, they would know why we set forth. They were our fellow sojourners. They were our friends. Today, up here where the blue sky turns to black, we can say at long last to Dick, Mike, Judy, to Ron and Al, and to Krista and Greg. Dear friends, we have resumed the journey that we promised to continue for you. Dear friends, your loss has meant that we could confidently begin anew. Dear friends, your spirit and your dream are still alive in our hearts.
A new tool for the 80s will be the space telescope, weighing 5 tons and measuring 43 feet long by 14 feet in diameter. The space telescope will give astronomers unprecedented views of space, unobstructed by the veil of the Earth's atmosphere. The new telescope observatory is scheduled to be placed in orbit by the space shuttle in the 1980s and will circle the Earth at an altitude of 310 miles.
Discovery, your go for umbilical disconnect.
We copy that. Go for umbilical disconnect.
It's firm.
Hey, in Houston, don't know whether you were watching or not. The umbilicals are disconnected. There was a good, clean separation confirmed visually on TV monitors.
Discovery, the SA forward latches are released.
We copy story. Forward latches are released.
Today. Somewhat like our integrated sims, but came off okay in the end. The telescope really looked great as we flew away from it. And we're all remarking about we sure hope it does good work.
Well, it sure is now, Lorne. And thanks for all the great work you've done. Pleasure working with you. Galileo is real proud of you.
That's our pleasure, too.
See you tomorrow.
Okay, bye. Houston Discovery.
Go ahead, Lauren.
For those technically inclined this morning, I'd like to pass on the quote of the day from the onboard astronomer, something to the effect that the big marble sure looks far away today.
Sure it does. Further away than anyone in the shuttle yet.
I've noticed that as we meet other people and do some traveling around the country, talking to different groups of people, almost everybody seems to be familiar with what the Hubble Space Telescope is and what it was designed to do. And that just sort of automatically heightens the awareness, I think, of the country as a whole as to the payload and the importance of the mission. So I think I felt something a little more special that way than what I did before. Just like Lauren says, and I think all of us have said in private conversation, it's hard to go somewhere and find someone who has never heard of Hubble and the Hubble Space Telescope. It makes little kids' eyes light up. It makes little kids want to learn how to add and subtract and study science, and that's extremely gratifying to see that we're a part, to know that you're a part of a mission that seems to have excited the nation as well as the world about something.
The one with about a minute to take slip.
Okay. Look.
Okay.
What's our range limit on that?
I believe it's about 360 feet or so.
No flight payments.
Go ahead.
We have we've lost PDI decom lock completely now.
Flight we see quad correcting for attitude at the hover position. X, Y, and Z look good.
Copy.
Space telescope captain.
Houston Endeavour has a firm handshake with Mr. Hubble's telescope.
We copy that, Chevy, and there are smiles galore down here.
It's quite a sight.
We can't wait to see.
We are in drift mode, and Sun Point is disabled.
Okay, and we see that.
Copy flight.
We see that, and just for the benefit of the rendezvous folks up there, your prop margins were well within what we predicted. Great work up there, you guys.
Okay, that's a good height. Keep coming in. Okay, hello, story. You happy?
Yes.
Okay, squad, let's move back.
Okay, move
away.
Okay, move away.
Okay, let's...
Okay, so let's, I guess, go up to the very top with Jeff and bring it out to the hard stop with the Essex.
What I really want to see is if I can...
And we're going to try that, if that's okay.
EVA copy.
Press on, Tom. If you've got a way to do it, do it.
Endeavour, you've got to go for release, and I have your backup Sun Point timer init time when you're ready to copy.
Roger, copy, go for release, and KT's ready to copy. TIG SEP was 1 hour, 0 minutes, 22 seconds.
Copy, 1 hour, 0 minutes, 22 seconds, Cubby. And we have to say that through your superb efforts, you have really shown that NASA can do all that we promised to do and more, and we very much appreciate it. Thank you.
понятно, но вопрос, готовы к спросу давления? Это вопрос на странице 152.
Houston, Atlantis. Out to the ODS whenever you're ready.
Go ahead, sir.
Yeah, that all went very well according to the procedure and without any difficulty. I have removed and stowed the three identified caps, the fore and aft sections of the booster fan, and at the aft end of the mixing box, forward of the ODS. I verified good airflow coming out the top of the outlet there, around the top of the halo and the external airlock, top of the ODS, in other words. And the payload isolation valve was closed. It is open. I think that's it. Let me know if you have any questions, but I think we've got a good configuration.
You get this big caution on the jar or bang it or anything like that, so you make it just really different.
На 9 мая звездам.
Геннадий.
Какие планы планируются?
Ну, у нас массовое гуляние. У нас парад 8 будет даже. На репетиции. Я уже не помню, сколько лет его не было, но, наверное, лет.
We may use some of this KU time to get that to you. Atlantis Houston, we show vestibule pressurization complete. And please coordinate with the Mir crew for the leak check. Okay, Dave, we'll look at that. say almost 10 feet.
Okay, thank you.
Oh, this is great.
Ellen, here you can see us deploying the boom after the ATFR didn't work out. We had a lot of good handholds there, and I just felt that we could do this free float. And it was just a matter of keeping it under control and going slowly, and as you can see, it worked out pretty well.
This is great to see.
And this is video evidence for everyone on the ground that we did not damage the dish.
We copy. It just wasn't quite the same with SSV.
Houston, we're seeing correct motion up here physically.
Copy, and we see good numbers on the ground.
Copy, and we see good numbers on the ground. As we do up here.
What a beautiful piece of hardware.
We agree. It's the same Chris can't do this with the shuttle arm.
Well, you gotta have the big arm for that.
Window, but we also see them reflections of all the clouds go by reflected in the lab window. Yeah, it's beautiful. We are so pleased and excited and proud to be a part of the team that made this happen, and our special thanks to all the ISS folks, all their hard work.
International research mission finally underway.
Columbia, Houston, no response required. Just wanted to express the thanks from the Orbit One team to the crew and the great job you've all done. You've made our jobs extremely easy, and with the exception of a few of us, this is our last shift, and the majority of the team is coming back for asset entry. We'll consider them a different group, but the ones that won't be coming back are greatly appreciative of the job you guys have done. You made it very easy on us.
Well, Houston, we sure do appreciate it, and we appreciate all the great work. Okay, well, then we've got an announcement that we'd like to make on behalf of the SGS-107 crew.
and it goes like this. It is the day that we remember and honor the crews of Apollo 1 and Challenger. They made the ultimate sacrifice, giving their lives in service to their country and for all mankind. Their dedication and devotion to the exploration of space was an inspiration to each of us, and still motivates people around the world to achieve great things in service to others. As we orbit the Earth, we will join the entire NASA family for a moment of silence in their memory. Enjoy the ride, pal.
Nozzle check of the SRBs. Firing chain is armed. Sound suppression water system armed. T-minus 10, 9, 8.
Discovery Station on the Big Loop. Go ahead, Scott. Yes, Steve, as you guys are heading home, I wanted to say one last time that we really enjoyed your company on board, and I'm really proud of what we accomplished together as a team here on the space station, but also including the larger team in Houston and all the control centers around the world. This space program and doing something as complicated as this really takes a team effort, and I think what we've proven here this last week. I'd like to wish you guys a safe rest of your flight and a safe landing, and I will see you all back in Houston here in about a week or so. Thank you.
You know, the space shuttle is an amazing vehicle to fly through the atmosphere, hit it at Mach 25, steer through the atmosphere like an airplane, land on a runway. It is really, really an incredible ship. On behalf of my entire crew, I want to thank every person that's worked for to get this mission going and every person that's worked on Endeavour. It's sad to see her land for the last time, but she really has a great legacy.
Your will stop, and we'll take this opportunity to congratulate you, Atlantis, as well as the thousands of passionate individuals across this great spacefaring nation who truly empowered this incredible spacecraft, which for three decades has inspired millions around the globe. Job well done, America.
Hey, thanks, Butch. Great words. You know, the space shuttle's changed the way we view the world, and it's changed the way we view our universe. There's a lot of emotion today, but one thing's indisputable. America's not going to stop exploring. Thank you, Columbia, Challenger, Discovery, Endeavour, and our ship Atlantis. Thank you for protecting us and bringing this program to such a fitting end.
Dream is alive again. Let's keep it that way.
This special report brought to you by NASA, the National Aeronautics and Space Administration.